What's the difference between the NADH to NAD plus ratio and the NADPH to NADH ratio? Hi, I'm Chris Masterjohn, and I have a PhD in nutritional sciences. I am not a medical doctor, and nothing contained in this episode may be construed as medical or nutritional advice of any kind or a substitute, therefore. This episode is meant purely as scientific education. If you wish to act on any ideas presented in this episode, please consult your physician first and never take anything herein as a reason to contradict medical advice. With that said, enjoy the episode.
You talk about the NAD slash NADH ratio in your research. You also talk about the NADH slash NADPH ratio. Could you refresh our memory and tell us whether these ratios are meant to measure the same physiological processes or not? Yeah. And if they are, could you just give us, you know, just a quick feel for what they actually mean?
Got it. So the NADH to NAD ratio and the NADPH to NADP plus ratio are things that are having real consequences as ratios in biochemistry that are dictating what's going on in our body. The NADPH to NADH ratio is physiologically irrelevant, but is used as a biomarker of niacin status. So if you look at a biochemistry textbook that's telling you how things work in the body, you're going to see constant references to the NADH to NAD ratio or the NADPH to NADP plus ratio. And you're never going to see any reference to the NADPH to NADH ratio. The NADPH to NADH ratio is used to calculate the niacin number, which is used as a test for niacin status. And the logic of the niacin number is that antioxidant defense is so critical to cellular health that if you are niacin deficient, your NADH will go down, but your NADPH will stay constant as long as it can. And so generally, you will have a very high niacin number if you have an excellent amount of niacin, and you'll have a very low niacin number, meaning you'll have less NADH, but the same NADPH when you're low in niacin. So basically, the expectation is NADPH will remain relatively constant in deficiency, whereas niacin deficiency will selectively deplete the pool of NADH first. So that's one thing. That's a marker of nutritional status. The other ratios are not markers of nutritional status, but they're biochemically relevant. The marker of nutritional status has no biochemical relevance. So the NADH to NAD ratio is you're going to have more NADH when you are well-fed and less NADH when you are less well-fed. And you're going to have more NAD when you're burning energy, and you're going to have less NAD when you're not burning energy. So you can sort of imagine the maximal NADH to NAD ratio is going to be when you are overfed and sedentary, and the maximal or the minimal NADH to NAD ratio is going to be when you're fasting and you're doing exercise. And there are other things that can impact that, such as whether you're running on one fuel or another, like ketones will change one in the liver and change it in the opposite direction in the brain and stuff like that. But thinking of it as fed versus, you know, energy in versus energy out is the best way to think about it. The NADPH to NADP plus ratio is going to be highest when you have a high activity of the pentose phosphate pathway, and is going to be lowest when you have low activity of that pathway. It's generally going to be pretty constant because you want to operate that pathway quite well whenever you can. But if it's low, that's going to compromise your antioxidant defense and your ability to synthesize things like cholesterol, neurotransmitters, fatty acids, nucleotides, and to recycle folate and vitamin K. When it's high, all those processes will run smoothly. And recycling glutathione, I didn't mention. And also some detoxification as well. So generally, the reason you want a high, and so generally in health, you'll have a very high NADPH to NADP plus ratio, and you'll have a very low NADH to NAD plus ratio. And so NADPH is, you generally want high in health because it's helping you synthesize things, recycle things, and support antioxidant defense and detoxification. NADH, you generally want low, meaning you want high NAD plus, and that's because that's going to help you burn fuel in a very effective manner. If your NADH goes up too much, then that's signifying the overfed sedentary state. So those two ratios are biochemical. The other one, the ratio between those two different systems, is a marker of nutritional status. Does that help?
Yes, yes, it's very helpful. And so when you take nicotinamide riboside, do you impact these three ratios throughout, or do you, or not? And what is the benefit of, you know, NR supplements relative to these ratios, relative to better aging?
When you take NR, you will probably increase all those ratios, but because you're increasing the niacin number, which means you're having a better increase in the NADH pool than you are in the NADPH pool. And so if you're increasing that ratio, it by definition means that you're having a much bigger impact on the NADH pool than the NADPH pool. Now, that's probably contextual. You know, there might be some people where that average situation doesn't play out, or who are so deficient that they need not more niacin to support NADPH, but that's a general rule. You will increase all pools, but you will specifically favor NADH more than the other pool. And then NR is going to be better at supporting the production of NAD, of any of those systems than niacin or nicotinamide, whereas an NMN is probably equivalent to NR.
Very nice. Thank you, right. Chris.
You're
Thank
welcome, you. Xavier.
This episode was part of a Q&A for members of the CMJ MasterPass, a buyer's club with exclusive and massive discounts on your favorite premium foods and health products, including pasture-raised and wild meat and seafood, supplements, sleep accessories, water filters, phototherapy devices, and much more. As a bonus, you also get to participate in monthly private Zoom Q&As with me. You can join the MasterPass at chrismasterjohnphd.com/masterpass and use the code Q&A, spelled out as Q-A-N-D-A, Q&A, for a 10% lifetime discount. From now through February or March, whatever it takes to get it done, I will be working full-time on finishing my Vitamins and Minerals 101 book while reserving a portion of my time for my consulting clients. You can pre-order my book at chrismasterjohnphd.com/book. In my consulting, I am neither a medical practitioner nor a coach. I serve as your data analyst and your strategist. I teach you scientific principles of health and wellness, help you analyze your data, and help brainstorm actionable strategies. You can sign up for a consultation at chrismasterjohnphd.com/consultations. I will try to respond to comments here when I can, but my presence will be intermittent while I'm finishing my book. I hope you enjoyed this, and I will see you in the next episode.